presence of the Lord is here. Presence of the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere. Presence of the Lord is here. Oh, presence of the Lord is here. Spirit of the Lord is here. Anybody feel it tonight? Spirit of the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere. The Spirit of the Lord is here. Oh, the Spirit of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here. I feel it in the atmosphere. The power of the Lord is here. The power of the Lord is here.
Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, I love you in Jesus' name. Come on, show them some love. Show them some light. Show them some liberty.
Happy New Year's, church. My name is Kalik Spiriharu, and this is a good news announcement for the month of January. Welcome to St. John's United Methodist Church, the church in Watts with Watts at heart. Happy birthday to those who were all born in January. We wish you an amazing and blessed year. To kick off the new year, the Blazed Youth will start their new program. Second Sundays will be Blazed Fellowship at the church from 1 p.m. to 2:15 p.m. Third Sundays will be Teen Talk on Zoom from 1 p.m. to 1:45 p.m. And fifth Sundays will be Service Project Sundays, a way to give and serve others. The Blaze Youth First Service Project will be Warm the Heart. The youth will gather to pack up warm blankets to those in need on Sunday, January 30th. Contact Ms. Wynette Parker for more information. Looking to join the ministry the new year? The Sisters of Praise are always looking for people who love to sing. The sewing class will be starting up soon. Contact Ms. Heather Starling for more details. United Methodist Women meet on second Saturdays at 10 a.m. Maybe you would like to help with the food banks or the clothes closet. See Pastor Samuel. See the digital flyers for all other ministry updates and details. If you have a ministry announcement or want to highlight a ministry here, please contact Ms. Tricia. Please fill out the details, I am here attendant, and prayer request form each week so that you can participate in worship. Scan the QR code with your phone or click the link. See y'all next week, saints, and keep on praying.
And welcome to St. John's United Methodist Church, the church in Watts with Watts at heart. And we come today celebrating the goodness of God. Let us pray. God, we come in the name of Jesus, thanking you for the beauty of this day, for the witness of your Holy Spirit. and allow us to enter into your presence, to worship you in spirit and in truth. And we are forever grateful through the blood of Christ Jesus. Amen. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen and amen.
Call to worship. God built the heavens, the earth, and everything in them. God calls us to be builders as well. God calls us to build our lives, to restore broken places and continue to grow. God calls us to build our faith, to study the word and ponder its interpretation. God calls us to build our community, to build bridges of understanding and systems of justice. God calls us to build history by fulfilling the promise of Scripture, to preach the good news of God's love and liberation for all people.
Hallelujah, thou worthy to be praised. God, we come in the name of Jesus, thanking you for the beauty of this day. And God, we just thank you for being our creator, our sustainer, our giver of life. And we are forever grateful. God, we thank you that we can only know pieces of who your character is, whether it's faithful, whether it's loving, whether it's kind, whether it's compassionate. But God, we come in the name of Jesus, just praising you and giving you glory and worshiping you in honor and in truth. And God, we come just offering ourselves to you, knowing that it is by your Holy Spirit that we're able to confess Jesus as Lord. And we are grateful that your Holy Spirit has found rest in us. God, we come confessing that we may not have done all the things you desired us to do. God, we ask that you would forgive us through the blood of Christ Jesus, that you would allow your Spirit to continue to cut like a two-edged sword, that we would be convicted, that we would know your way and not our way. And God, we know that your way is far better than our way. And because it is far better than our way, God, allow your Spirit to continue to make revelation. And we are forever grateful. And God, we come thanking you for the beauty of the day, the witness of your love, the kindness of community. And we just praise you. And God, we come mourning. We come grieving with our sister family. And God, we just ask that your presence would surround them in ways to support them in the valley of the shadow of death, that they would know your witness as they grieve, as they mourn, as they celebrate the life and witness of Mary Brown. And we are forever grateful. And God, we come praying for those that are looking for peace, that are searching for a glimpse of joy. God, we ask that they would look inside themselves as one of your children, created in your very image. That the joy they seek is in you. The love they seek is in you, God. The witness is in you. That they would look at the sun and be reminded of your creation. That they would look at the moon and be reminded of your witness, even in the darkness. God, we thank you for Jesus Christ, the light, the bread of life, the lily of the valley. And we are forever grateful. And we pray that prayer Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Today's scripture reading is coming from Nehemiah chapter 8, verses 1 through 3, 5 through 6, 8 through 10, and Luke verses 14 through 21. And it begins, "And all the people gathered themselves together as one man into the street that was before the water gate. And they spake unto Ezra the scribe to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded to Israel. And Ezra the prince brought the law before the congregation, both of men and women, and all that could hear with understanding, upon the first day of the seventh month. And he read therein before the street that was before the water gate, from the morning until midday, before the men and the women, and those that could understand, and the ears of all the people were attentive unto the book of the law." Verse 5. "And Ezra opened the book in the sight of all the people, for he was above all the people, and when he opened it, all the people stood up. And Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God, and all the people answered, Amen, Amen, with lifting their hands. And they bowed their heads and worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. Verse 8. So they read in the book in the law of God distinctly and gave the sense and caused them to understand the reading. And now Nehemiah, which is in Tereshith, and Ezra, the priest, the scribe, and the Levites that taught the people, said unto all the people, This day is holy unto the Lord your God. Mourn not, nor weep. For all the people wept when they heard the words of the law. Then he said unto them, Go your way, eat the fat and drink the sweet incense portion unto them, from whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy unto our Lord. Neither be ye sorry, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Luke 4:14-21. Then Jesus, filled with the power of the Spirit, returned to Galilee, and a report about him spread through all the surrounding country. He began to teach in their synagogues and was praised by everyone. When he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as was his custom. He stood up to read. And the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." 20. And he rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the attendant, and sat down. The eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to say to them, "Today the scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Today in the sanctuary, the Reverend Christy Ann Clark will be bringing the message. And that as we continue in Bible study, we're mindful of Ezra and Nehemiah and the witness of the Israelites returning to the witness of Jerusalem to rebuild not only the temple, but the restoration of the wall around. There's something about community that joins us together. And I'm mindful this week in the upper room as The daily bread devotionals remind us that God's love is manifested through the witness of Jesus Christ. Jesus encountered the woman at the well, and for some reason this week it was just so funny to me that Jesus and this woman that is not named other than the Samaritan woman have this conversation, and how important this well was to her and the line of Jacob. But Jesus said, if you knew who I was, you would be asking for this living water. And she finally says, if it's greater than this well that Jacob built, then I want this water. There's something about tasting the witness of God's love as manifested through Jesus. So I invite you, people of God, to study God's word in ways that it would lighten you, would strengthen you, would give you strength for your journey. God bless you. Until we meet again. Amen.
Yes.
Come on. All right. Girl.
Yes.
Makes no difference what you're going through.
Yes.
You're gonna make it. God's gonna see you through.
Right.
These troubles and trials come to make you strong.
Yes.
Keep on believing. You keep holding.
Deuteronomy 14:23. Tithing is an act of worship.
God doesn't need your money, but your place of worship benefits from your giving by maintaining the ministries it offers. We have the food bank, the gardener, the clothes closet. We need cleaning supplies, water for our neighbors, out there on in the airways. So tithes and offerings is a very important part of who we are as Christians. I invite you to give your first fruits with a happy, loving heart. Times are hard, but trust God. In Malachi 3:10, God says, "Test me, and I will open up the windows of heaven for you and pour out all the blessings you need." Give your place of worship a tenth of what you earn. I believe if you do your best, God will still bless you. You can't beat God giving no matter how hard you try. So participate in worship by giving your tithes. You can mail them to the church or drop them off on Sunday. And for more information, call the church at 323-564-5638. Thank you, family.
Maybe I can get somebody over here that believes what I'm doing.
Holy,
holy,
yes you are,
yes you are,
you are so faithful,
you are so faithful.
Holy,
holy,
yes you are,
yes you are,
you are so faithful,
you are so faithful.
Righteous,
righteous,
yes you are,
yes you are,
you are so faithful,
you are so faithful.
All that you are,
you are.